Most of us know by now that Amazon is the largest online retailer. People often go directly to Amazon when considering a purchase before searching anywhere else. And when they do implement a search, as on Google, Amazon is usually the top-ranking search result. Now try imagine coming up with a marketing campaign to compete with that. The good news is, you don't have to. Amazon had provided the means to share that traffic with you. Additionally, many buyers choose product by FBA sellers instead of merchant-fulfilled sellers, even when the price is higher, because they know it comes with Amazon's reliability. So, what exactly is Amazon's Fulfillment by Amazon? With FBA, your products are stored at Amazon's fulfillment centers. They do the packing, the shipping, and the customer service. Plus, products sold can be eligible for Amazon Prime's free 2-day shipping, free shipping, and other benefits provided directly by Amazon. Now, you can automatically market your products across North America. When you register for an Amazon.com seller account, you can enable FBA for products you list to be seen on Amazon.ca and Amazon.com.mx. This allows you to sell on Amazon's marketplaces in Canada and Mexico, reaching even more customers. What it will cost you? You're charged for storage space in the orders they fulfill. The cost of shipping is included in your fees, with no extra charge for Amazon's free 2-day shipping and free shipping on eligible orders. Fees for optional services may apply. When deciding whether or not to expand your sales via FBA, one step that will help you will be to check whether your product is in one of the categories requiring approval. If it is, submit the product for approval and go from there. If it isn't, then you're ready to start. Upload your product onto the FBA platform, finalize your listing, and then box up your products and ship them to an Amazon distribution center. One thing to keep in mind, your inventory may not all go to one place, but might need to be separated among more than one of Amazon's distribution centers. Fortunately, the FBA platform allows you to pause shipments to wait until you have multiple items ready for the same location. This will save you on shipping costs. You can save even more if you take advantage of Amazon's partnership with UPS. Once your items arrive and are scanned in at the distribution center, they live on Amazon. If items don't sell within the preset time period, you can either pay storage fees or have them returned to you at your expense. As with any new venture, there are pros and cons to weigh before making a final decision. Pros: enormous customer base. As one of the largest online retailers, Amazon users are looking to shop. Credibility and trust. Buyers are comfortable going to Amazon than an individual e-commerce site. Excellent support. Everything from inventory tracking, tax collection, to credit card processing is already set up with Amazon's platform. Referrals. Amazon's built-in algorithms include your product in their recommended purchases section found at the bottom of product pages. This means a buyer on Amazon can get exposure to your product as a recommended purchase. And Amazon affiliates will also link buyers to your items through blog and social media posts. Cons. Fees. These start at a minimum of $1 and can go as high as 25% of the product's price. You're a commodity. On Amazon, you're mostly a commodity. This means that there will be other merchants undercutting your prices. Plus, you're competing directly with Amazon for any products they sell. No control over branding. Unlike on your own site, there are few options to promote your own brand. Lack of customer loyalty. Customers are finding your products due to their loyalty to Amazon, not you. Some other things to consider. Once you ship your products off to Amazon, you're no longer in control of what happens to your items. You are, however, responsible for them. Plan for return or damaged items. Amazon's 100% satisfaction guarantee extends to your items, giving your customers additional peace of mind. So when pricing, you should allow 3-5% of items to come back that can't be resold. A note on keeping your own e-commerce website. At this point, you may be thinking that this could replace your own e-commerce site. Many experts recommend keeping your existing site as well. The primary reason being, when you sell on other platforms, you don't actually own your own shop. They will reserve the right to manage your product listings, and not always in a way that is in your best interests. This could even include preventing you from selling within a certain category if they make more of a product selling the similar items in-house. Overall, Amazon's FBA platform is an excellent opportunity to increase sales and distribution without having to increase your own storage and shipping facilities. For more information, or to get started, visit Fulfillment by Amazon now. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. If you found it informative and would like to see others, please subscribe below so we can keep you informed as more become available.